Welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Ujaswi Bhalla, research scholar at Jawaharlal Nehru University, and I am presenting today on behalf of Professor Jayaseelan. The module I will be covering now is module number 15 of the paper Advanced Syntax titled Minimalist Inquiries 1. Let us begin. So in today's module, we'll be covering some introductory part, the probe call mechanism of feature checking, the EPP feature, and active-inactive goal. Chomsky's 1998 paper, Minimalist Inquiries, which was published in 2000, made a number of changes to the minimalist program as it stood at that point and presented in his first minimalist paper, A Minimalist Program for Linguistic Theory, 1992. In this module, we are going to discuss the changes he proposed and the rationale for these changes. Feature checking theory established so far could be stated as finite T has a plus nominative case feature. Subject NP moves to the specifier position of TP. It matches its case feature with the nominative feature of T. If subject also has a plus nominative case feature, then the features match and the case features on the T head bleeds. In case of mismatch of features, case features of T head does not delete, and this case feature of T reaches LF level. At LF, this derivation crashes. After checking case feature, subject moves up into the specifier position of AGR head. Subject has inherent and meaningful person number gender features. Person number gender features could also be stated as 5 features. AGR head also has 5 feature set, but this is solely for the purpose of subject verb agreement. If the feature sets of AGR and subject match, then PNG features of AGR head delete, and this derivation converges at LF. Now both the feature checking operations of case and phi set is done in a specifier head configuration, specifier of TP for case and specifier of AGRP for phi features. Chomsky 1992 generalized this to include all feature checking and stated that all feature checking, both case checking and phi feature checking, must be done in spec head configuration. For this reason, he postulated an AGR OP layer over little VP layer. Verb raises to AGRO head and object moves to the specifier position of AGRP. Checking of accusative case of the object and checking of the 5 features of AGR head in case of an object agreement language is done in this spec head configuration. Now Chomsky was dissatisfied with the analysis proposed so far, which led to the build-up of probe goal mechanism of feature checking. Two major reasons for his dissatisfaction were that though there is evidence for subject raising to a higher position in the clause above tense, there is no such evidence for the raising of object in world's languages. In fact, we are forced to say that the raising of object for case and phi feature checking is a covert movement, and this is required only for a theoretical claim. The second reason for his dissatisfaction was that the AGRS head above TP consisted only of 5 features, which got deleted after a successful matching with the subject's 5 feature when subject moves into the AGRS head and matches its 5 feature set with the 5 feature set of AGR head. After deletion, AGR head has nothing in it. So, we can't have an empty head projecting a phrase at any level of derivation. Because of these two reasons, Chomsky in his later paper abandons both AGRSP and AGROP. Now, tense and agreement do not project separate phrases, but they have only one head, one verbal inflectional head, which was called infill or I or T. This head has both tense and agreement features in it. Also, now the little V head carries 5 features for the purpose of checking of 5 features of the object, besides its own verbal features. The five-feature checking function, which was earlier the role of AJRO head, is now taken over by the little V head. This led to the development of a new mechanism for agreement and case feature checking. T head has inherent tense feature, which could either be plus past or minus past. This is plus interpretable on it because it is meaningful for the tense head. It also has five features for the purpose of checking the subject's five feature. These are minus interpretable for the tense feature because five features are nominal features and they make no sense on a functional category. Now it's important to note that an uninterpretable feature must be deleted before the derivation reaches LF. Minus interpretable features came to be called as probe. A probe looks down the tree for an NP to agree with. This is called the goal. The first NP which a probe finds is the subject, subject being the highest argument in the clause, and matches PNG features with it. If probe goal have the same features, matching is successful and the probe deletes. Remember, probe is the uninterpretable features of a head. A major development in the theory came now because now it is stated that subject NP, in fact all NPs, are generated with an unfilled case feature. An important difference in the theory came now because subject NP, in fact all NPs, are now generated with an unfilled case feature. It is marked as plus nominative only as a reflex of successful matching of feature with T's probe. Little V has uninterpretable five features on it which now act as a probe. This probe looks down for a goal in the VP domain. On finding object, matching of feature takes place and if successful, the probe deletes. Unfilled case feature of objects gets marked as plus accusative as a reflex of successful matching of V's feature. It's important to note now that NPs get marked plus nominative or plus accusative depending on which probe, whether it be T head or little V head, it matches its features with. Now, T head or little V head are not lexically endowed with plus nominative or plus accusative features. From all this mechanism, it became apparent that case marking by T or V is a more appropriate term than case checking by T or V, because case is getting marked and not checked by T or V. Let us talk about the EPP feature now. So, no movement is required for case marking of subject and object. This is done in C2 now. In GB, case was the one which drove all the movement of NPs. But in minimalist inquiries, case marking and movement are completely divorced. So how do we account for subject moving to spec TP? The answer came in the form of extended projection principle, referred to as EPP. Projection principle, which was earlier discussed in module 8, ensured that all theta positions are represented in syntax. But subject position is not a theta position. It can be filled by a dummy element like it or there. Projection principle does not talk about this, nor does it require it to be obligatorily generated and filled. This was a lack in the form of theory. Because we need a rule for every clause to have a subject. So for this, we extended the projection principle and stated EPP as the subject position of a clause must be filled. In the new theory, EPP was used more loosely. If a head has an EPP feature, then the specifier position of that head must be filled. When the specifier is filled, EPP feature of the head is deleted. A new theory assumes that it is the T head that is lexically marked with a plus EPP feature. Being uninterpretable on the T head, it has to be checked and deleted before the derivation reaches LF. For this, subject moves to SpecTP. Once the subject has moved to SpecTP, it checks and deletes the EPP feature of the T-head, and because of this, the derivation converges at LF. Now, EPP feature can be checked by an expletive it or thereto. For this, see the sentence on your screen. Sentence 1, arrived a packet by the morning post. Subject position as of now is empty. This could be filled by an expletive there, with which we get the sentence 2, there arrived a packet by the morning post. Now, in the case of expletive insertion not happening, then one has to move subject NP to SpecTP to check and delete EPP feature of the T-head. A packet arrived by the morning post. You see the trace being left behind by a packet in sentence 3 on your screen. Now that we have talked about EPP, let us talk about what an active and an inactive goal is. We now have stated that all NPs are generated with an unfilled case feature. This feature must be filled with a case feature of some probe. An unfilled case feature, if it reaches LF, it crashes the derivation there. This became the new version of case filter in the minimalist program. Now, new theory states that as long as an NP has an unfilled case feature, it is active. That is, it is receptive to a probe and to EPP. Once its case feature gets filled, it becomes inactive, meaning it remains frozen in place. To see this, let us see evidence from data. The sentence is on your screen. Seems that John has been killed. John gets nominative case assigned to it by probe of the embedded finite T. It gets pulled from the lower position to the subject position by the EPP feature of the SpecTP of the embedded clause. You can see the movement happening on your screen. What is to prevent matrix finite T from reassigning nominative case to John and pulling it up to the matrix specifier position of TP for its own EPP feature? This would become a derivation like as shown on your screen. John has moved from the subject position of has been killed higher up to the subject position of seems. Now, this second movement is disallowed if we state that John is inactive. If its case feature has already been filled, then it can't become a goal for a higher up probe. The only way to save the derivation now would be expletive insertion. And we see this happening on your screen, where John remains in the subject position of the embedded clause, and we have it, an expletive pleonastic element, getting inserted in the subject position of seems. From this we get the correctly grammatical sentence, it seems that John has been killed. It's important to note now that five feature probe of T and its EPP feature can act independently. See the sentence on your screen, sentence 1, seems John to have been killed. Now, to have been killed, the embedded T is non-finite. It does not have PNG features because there is no agreement. Thus, it cannot act as a probe, but it still has an EPP feature to satisfy, for which it pulls up NP from the lower position to the subject position of the embedded clause. And we have the movement in sentence 1, John coming up from its lower position. Now, NP's case feature is still unfilled, therefore it is still active in our feature checking mechanism, and this can become the goal for matrix T's probe. This matrix T then finds its goal in John, which is the subject right now at the subject position of the embedded clause. It values its case feature down below and pulls it up to the matrix spec TP position for its own EPP. Because of this, we get the structure number 2, where John has risen a second time from the middle position to the higher position. So with this, we conclude this module in which we saw some innovations in the minimalist program from Chomsky's 2000 paper. And we will be continuing forward with more innovation in the Minimalist program in the next module. Thank you.